In today's video, I'm going to show you how to turn this into this. When generated AI images for stories, a lot of people are still struggling to generate consistent characters, but creating the scene that matches exactly how you imagine can also be a challenge. It is especially important when your stories require special interactions between characters or specific elements in the scene to drive the narrative forward. Now, with Adobe's new feature Structure Reference, you can take control and bring your artistic visions to life with incredible precision. And I'll share with you a secret tool that is free and powerful to give you the ultimate facial and detail control. You wouldn't want to miss it. Let's get started. First, we go to firefly.adobe.com. All the links mentioned will be in the descriptions below. Sign in and hit generate. And then we'll get to the image generation workspace. In here, we have the side panel, prompt box, and after we hit generate, the results will show up here. On the left setting panel under the general settings, you'll find the most updated version here, Firefly Image 2. And you can choose the aspect ratio here. Here, I'm gonna choose landscape. I find that it is best to choose the same orientation as your original image for structural reference, or else it would sometimes not reference the whole structure as if some parts were cut off. Under content type, you can choose photo if you want to generate photos with photorealistic results, or art for more illustrative or digital art generations. If you want to create photorealistic images, you can also further adjust the aperture, shutter speed, and field of view for your photos. Here we're choosing art since I'm creating an animation illustration. Under structure, here's where you can put your reference image for structural reference. Adobe will take the layout of the image as a structural reference template and generate multiple image variations with the same layout. If you just want to test, you can use one of their preset examples here to try. To upload your own image, you can find a stock image or a photo you find online that is close to your imagination for the structural reference. Back to our tutorial, we want to use our hand-drawn picture like this one I have for reference. This is apparently not a masterpiece, but let's see if it can bridge the gap between stick figures and fine art. So in here, I have a fairy sitting on a flower-like thing with a flower canopy and a girl on the right, and a butterfly in the middle. This flower-like structure is completely based on my imagination, so I don't even know how to describe it in text prompt. But with structure reference, I hope it can recreate what I have in mind. And the apple is just there because I want to add more challenges to see if it will work. And note that although you don't have to be a skilled artist, the proportion and shapes of the hand-drawn image would still affect the outcome. So the closer it can be to your imaginary result, the better. And later I found out that the scribble I drew is actually not very ideal. For example, I didn't even bother to draw the hands of this girl, so all the images turned out to have no hands. Just pay a little bit more attention to the details you find important, if you can. Under strength, you can adjust how much you want the result to follow the outline and depth of the original image. The more to the right, the more it will be closer to the original. In this tutorial, because I want it to be very close to what I have in my reference, so I keep it to the maximum. Next, we can use the style reference to influence the overall look and feel of the image. You can use one of their example as style reference in here, or you can upload your own image as style reference. Here we will upload this image that has the style I'm looking for. In my test, I find that the composition of the style reference image would actually also affect the final generation. So you will want to choose an image that is very similar to the image of your dream scene, or you will want to experiment lowering the visual intensity and strength of the style reference so you can lower the influence of the style reference. The visual intensity can adjust the intensity of the photo's visual attributes. The higher and to the right it is, the more it will reference the visual characteristics of your photo. Strength affects the strength of style matching and effects. The higher it is, the higher the style and effect you set up here will influence the outcome. Coming down to effect, if you have a specific style you're looking for, you can assign the effect in this section. You can play around and try for yourself. but I don't tend to use it as I prefer to use the prompt and reference images to create my ideal results. And also note that any additional specification would also get it farther from our structured reference, because the more input you get, the more it's likely to get confused. And in the prompt box, I will try to describe the objects and their relationships to start off. And also, if you have the suggestions toggle on as you type, it will give you suggestions to complete your prompt. It gives you some ideas if you don't have a set scene in mind, but don't get distracted as we are trying to recreate an image we've already had in mind. Also, I found that the more you describe here, the more it would deviate from our structure reference image. So we want to keep this concise. Okay, so here I have a fairy sitting in a flower with a flower canopy, a butterfly in the center, an apple on the ground, and a little girl on the right. Then we hit generate. You will then see four variations of the generated results. So for these results, it feels like it didn't actually take into consideration of the structural reference. And I think it's because the text prompt sort of confused the AI, and I think it mixed up the little girl with the fairy. So to correct this, I want to further minimize my text prompt to be as simple as possible. So here I type a fairy sitting in a flower with a flower canopy, a butterfly, an apple. Like, almost not describing anything. I only include the object and not too much details. And I also left out the little girl because after testing, I find it's hard to separate the fairy and the little girl for some reason. I kept the style reference the same to the maximum. Let's try it again. I think these are better, right? The layouts are pretty much the same, and it even stays true to my handless little girl. And you can see that the flower petals and the shapes are almost the same as the one I had. A lot of the details are not perfect, but I think the overall look is pretty good, and I like how it matched the style reference perfectly with my structure reference. I like this one, so let's work on it. Oh, forgot to mention that after you generate something you like, you'd want to favorite it by clicking the star icon. Adobe Firefly doesn't keep your generation history unless you favorite the image. So make sure to do that, and later you can find your images in the favorite section. For some reason, Adobe Firefly almost always generates messed up faces, like doll that got punched in the face and couldn't quite bounce back. Let's try to see if we can use generative fill here to fix this. When you hover over to the image's left top corner, you can find edit. Then we click generative fill. On the left hand side, we're set to use insert, and our cursor will become the brush to mark the area we want to edit. Now let's enter the text prompt to guide the generation for the fairy.
Ooh. This is not very good.
After you hit generate, you get three variations. You can click more to see more options. Click the arrow left or right to go through your variations. If you find something you like, hit keep. Here I'll fast forward the editing steps using generative fill. Adobe Firefly is trained on Adobe stock images, openly licensed content, and public domain content. So it is designed to be safe for commercial use. And also probably because of this approach, their artistic style has their unique flavors and the looks may not be as refined as the other tools. Adobe Firefly often creates eerie looking faces for human characters. Sometimes you might hit the jackpot and get a decent face on a good day, but today's probably not the day. So next we're going to use a powerful tool to do some cosmetic makeover on our characters. Let's download the image and give permission to its content credential policy. Next, we will be using Styler AI to fine-tune the image. Let's go to styler.ai, click start for free, and let's sign in. On the dashboard, you can see their predefined styles that you can generate similar results, but I'm not going into details for this video. Let's open a new project. In the pop-up, you can add your project name and change your canvas dimension. Select one and click Apply. And here you can see your free credits and the next reset date. On the onset, you should have 200 credits to use. And you can click deduction rules for more details. First, I'm gonna click import images and then upload the one that we've got. Before we begin, I want to mention that Styler AI can actually generate images using your provided image as structure reference under the image to image tool. You can play around yourself to see if you like this one better or Adobe Firefly. Let me know in the comment below. Back to our original workflow. First, I want to correct the look of the fairy. We click generative fill, then we click brush, and then adjust the brush size here. Then we brush over the area we want to edit. Click done. And then we enter the text prompt of the desired content in the mark area. Under the control method, you get to choose which source of guidance is more important when generating the mark area. Prompt will get you closer to the prompt. Image is more for structural reference of the painted area. And balance is between these two. I find that balance gives me the best result for this one, so I click balance and then hit stylize. It will then give you four results at the same time, and you can preview them by hovering over them. If the results are too much of a horror movie, hit stylize again and pray for better luck. Select one you like and hit place on canvas. You'll notice a new layer appears in the right layer panel, similar to what you might see in Photoshop. To hide or show the layer, simply toggle the eye icon on the right. You can also right-click on any layer for additional actions. Layers can also be reordered by dragging them. The layer at the top of the stack will be displayed in the foreground and vice versa. Next, we're going to edit the little girl with the face kit. Let's use the repair function and let's click mark the area. And then we brush over the face area of the little girl. In this box, you can type in what you want to see, but this is optional. I wanted to see if I can enhance the expression of the girl, but after I feel like this is probably not a good prompt for this one. Maybe you can think of a better prompt. In preserve original face, you can adjust how much you want the face to look like the original. And then we hit stylize. I think this one is better looking. Let's place on canvas. What if we want the little girl to look like a consistent character we built? Under face kit, you can find swap. In here, you can upload an image of your character. I'm using this one I generated before. On target face, hit detect. It has detected two faces in the image. And then we select the little girl we want to swap and hit confirm and then stylize. I don't think they look anything like the image I uploaded. Let's try another face again. Let's see. This is better. You probably won't get it right for the first time. Sometimes need a bit trials and errors to get to your dream results. With some more editing, I eventually get to something like this. Here's the final result. What do you think?
Thanks for watching. For more insights on how to bring out your creative vision to life, check out these videos. And I will see you soon.